know, and I've spoken to some people that say that they're struggling to hear from God. Like, how do I actually hear from God? So I've written some points down, just to give you a how to hear from God, if that makes sense. So stay tuned to the video. Hi guys, welcome back to Crystal Display. So today's topic is about how do I hear from God. Okay, so just before I start, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like these and more inspirational and motivational videos. Don't forget to click the bell notification to know that whenever I have uploaded, so you'll be notified about my video. Okay, so now that we get that out the way, so the first thing to do to hear from God is giving thanks. So giving thanks is just being grateful, if that makes sense. So what I have done, I got myself a gratitude journal. So you can get any gratitude journal from Amazon. So I got mine from Amazon or anywhere else. Or if you don't want to get a gratitude journal, you can simply get a simple notebook and then just write down each and every day what you're grateful for. So that is just tip number one, giving thanks to God for life and health and all that jazz. So number two is give praise and worship. So praise and worship is just about singing. So praise and worship is about singing songs and having that attitude of worship. So it's just the way you worship God as well, and just being humble before his presence and, you know, acknowledging his presence each and every day. So that is basically what praise and worship is. So it's not just about singing, it's about your behavior, your lifestyle. How does that actually show acknowledgement to God? So yeah. And number three is communicating or talking openly or praying to God daily. So when you do that, you build a relationship with God. Praying is just this long prayer. Say, oh God, I thank you for life and for breath, and long out the prayer. No, prayer is just simply talking to your friend. It's like, oh, me, I talk to you right now. That's the same way how we talk to God, same way, no difference. Because, you know, you just be real and be genuine. The same way you be real and genuine to your friend, you be real and genuine to God. So that's what prayer is, you being genuine to God and talking to him. Yeah, that's it. That's all I have to say about prayer. And then number four is preparing your mind to listen. So sometimes we tend to pray, and we don't take the chance to listen for a response from God. Yeah, that's it. So yeah, take a time to just pray. You pray first, yes, and then you just pause. Like, do a pause and just listen. Because there are many ways that God talk. God talk through his word, through songs, through dreams, etc. The list goes on and on. So take a time and just pause after you pray and tell him about what you're going through. Just pause for a response. Because trust me, God, if you pray that for God to respond, he will respond to you. Because I've many times in my life, for example, just read the Bible. Because when I was low and down back in university again, I read this psalm, and it was about joy comes in the morning, and it really encouraged my heart. So yeah, God actually cares about us and he wants the best for us. So yeah, just be real and open and be willing to listen to what he wants you to do. There was one instance where I was fasting, and they're probably gonna be watching this anyway, so let's just be honest. So I was fasting one time, and God said, sometime my family can be a headache. They know this. While I was fasting, it's like God said, the Holy Spirit said to me, you need to pray for your sister. And I was like, and so I looked, and I'm just like, I should pray for my sister that gives me trouble every single day. I should pray for her. But you know, that's human nature. My human nature said, why should I pray for her when she's the one that trying to, you know, cause trouble for my life sometimes. But I obeyed, and I called her directly, and I just decided to pray for her. And believe it or not, yeah, like, she was having the worst time at work, and I didn't know, because we don't live together anymore. So she was having the worst time at work. Okay, so number five is having a relationship with God. So how do you actually have a relationship with God? Well, if you check Romans 10 verse 9 to 10, I believe, it just talks about how to be saved. So that's how you have a relationship with God, by confessing to God that, you know, I'm not perfect, I've sinned against you, and I received Jesus as my Lord and Savior. And that's how you have a relationship. That's how you start the relationship with God. And then once you become saved and all that jazz, then you and God is like, and you need to communicate with Him and spend more time in His Word. Then that's how you have that relationship with God. And okay, so of course, most times, if you know me, I tend to give a bonus. So the bonus is having that attitude of expectancy. So meaning, when we ask God, or when we pray to God for something or to hear from Him, you should have that expectancy to hear from Him. That makes sense. Yeah. So if you pray to God, oh God, I want to hear from you, you should expect to hear from God. And that is about having faith and believing that God can answer, and that He will answer you. Those are my tips, I guess, to hear from God. I hope it was helpful. Let me know down below, what are some of the tips that you would recommend in hearing from God. So I forgot to mention that once you become saved, so once you've accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, in the Bible, when you read it, in John, the book of John, it says that that's when God gives us the Holy Spirit, which is the helper, to basically carry on with this, to be a Christian and live a life for Christ. So once you get saved, God is not just going to leave you like that and expect you to live by your own will. He actually gives us a helper, which is the Holy Spirit, that helps us to walk like Christ. I hope I was clear. If any confusion, just leave a comment down below, and I'll try to answer to the best of my ability with the Bible. Connect to stay tuned to my channel. Don't forget to leave a like again, as I said, and subscribe again, as I said, and stay tuned for the next video. I'll see you guys later. Bye. What was the point of me styling my edges? What was the point? You turn on the volume now?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. All right. I think I'm ready. every time. Why do I always say that? I think I'm ready. All right. Okay.